All right, I'm a huge fan of the Rolling Stones, and they're coming to Hollywood, Florida, which is near where I live, and the Hard Rock Live venue is a complete ripoff. It's the guitar-shaped hotel that everybody wants to check out and see and gamble in, but whenever there's a concert there, I automatically know that I can't go to that concert because it's going to be extremely expensive and overpriced. And let me prove my point. It's so expensive and overpriced that I honestly don't know who can even afford this. Like, you literally have to be a millionaire to go to this show or sacrifice a lot of money. Like, the average person cannot afford to sacrifice. The cheapest ticket is $1,357 for the worst seat. The worst seat all the way in the back is $1,300. Oh, now it's adjusting the price based on demand. $1,394. And I really don't believe that this is truly accurate. I don't believe any of these seats are actually sold out. I think what they're doing, this is the scam that they're doing on Ticketmaster. They're opening up seats little by little to try to look like it's sold out. But these tickets went on sale today, right? And look how specifically scattered it is. Look where all these seats are scattered, right? This is very strategic, and they just keep popping up. If you stay on this window long enough, you'll notice that more seats start to pop up and pop up slowly. So they're making it look like, oh, it's sold out instantly. So they can charge a few thousand dollars just for these seats, which is a scam, right? And I've noticed that the Hard Rock venue does this in particular. I mean, a lot of venues do this on Ticketmaster, and they adjust the price according to demand. But, you know, usually it's not this bad. Usually it's like 200, 100, you know, it depends on what show you're seeing. But this is literally insane. So they're trying to create all this demand and say, oh, there's limited supply. And they're trying to rip people off to see the Rolling Stones. Like, who can afford $2,000? Because once you add in the fees, a $1,357 ticket becomes like $1,700. Who can afford almost $2,000 for a 1.5 hour event? That's crazy. Literally, you're only gonna have 7,000 millionaires in this show. So let's go to just a regular Rolling Stone concert that's not in the Hard Rock, right? And you'll see the prices are significantly different. So yes, these other venues have more seats, right? So that's the only real difference. But let's look in Tampa, right? $97 for the cheapest seat. Come on. And some of these close seats, look at this. Let's click here. $347 for an actually close seat to a Rolling Stones concert. So that's actually somewhat affordable, and you're close and you could actually see it. So why is Tampa so much different than the Hard Rock? Well, obviously this is a much bigger venue, but I think they're genuinely scamming people at the Hard Rock. They're just showing that there's a few seats open. And you know what, I have a feeling more and more are gonna start opening up and they're gonna start lowering the prices. So they're doing this on the first day to see, oh, who will pay these exorbitant amounts for the tickets, and then they're just gonna drop significantly. So I don't like this. I'm not saying that this is a fact, this is my opinion, but I mean, come on, this is what it looks like. So if this information helped you, please share it, because I think this is horrible what they're doing. More people should be able to see the Rolling Stones. It should be more affordable. It shouldn't be like this. So please share this. Please like, please subscribe. Thank you. Have a great, great day.